So over the next half hour or so, we're going to do two exercises. And, you know, as you saw in the presentation, we are in what is probably the second major phase of the plan. Existing conditions was done. There were a variety of ways to engage on that. This is the visioning phase, and this is for us as a project team and for you as a community to really think about the ideal future for this station area. And so we are going to be doing two exercises, one which is one that I kind of like to do, which is the six-word story. The six-word story is based on an Ernest Hemingway contest, and it's an opportunity to provide feedback in a really nice, concise, succinct sort of way. When Ernest Hemingway did this contest, the winning six-word story was "For sale, baby shoes never worn." Your comments don't need to be exactly six words, so don't stress about it. But what we'd like to do is give you a little bit of an opportunity to tell your vision for the station area in six words. What I like about this exercise, as you're thinking about this, what I like about this exercise is that the project team can use your words directly to come up with a vision statement for this study area. It is your words. We can see what themes arise out of all of the six-word stories. And it's kind of a creative, different way to express your perspective other than just using a comment sheet. So I know this is sometimes an awkward part of any discussion, but I want to give you a quiet couple minutes to think about your six-word story for the future of the station area. There's some examples up at the top of how to think about this. It could be six words, comma, comma, comma. It could be a sentence. It could be something that's popping into your head. Don't worry about the pressure of coming up with something brilliant like a professional poet. So I'm going to give you just a couple minutes of quiet, nice silence, and feel free to start putting them in the chat box as soon as you come up with something. Are there any questions about that? I'm assuming no. So go ahead and do that if you would.
I just wanted to remind everyone in the room, and I think Zach's going to send around a reminder in a minute, but if you are commission or county staff, you shouldn't participate in the visioning exercise. We really want to hear from our members of the public. Just observe and be available to answer questions. Thanks.
Thanks, Scott. I'm starting to see some of them come through, so I will start putting them in.
So we have one idea from Miriam, which is a place I would like to go, comfortable, easy to get to, and fun. Christian has suggested transformative live, work, and play destination.
Thank you, Sarah.
If Miriam or Christian would want to elaborate on any of those or talk about it, feel free to unmute yourself.
Yep, I'm going to put in yours, Miriam, right now.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean, I'm just thinking like an example, like Faneuil Hall. You know, it's beautiful, it's colorful, it's a place you want to go, it's a place you want to take people. I'm not originally from the DC area, and I have a lot of visitors that come. And so I would love some place that I could show off. That would be wonderful. And then also just a place, you know, to eat lunch or a place that I would find comfortable to be, or a place that I'd want to go.
Thank you. Remind me whose was the transformative live, work, and play destination?
That was me.
Do you want to elaborate on that, Christian? What were you thinking?
Sure. So I think it needs to be a balanced approach. I think there needs to be, graduate student housing. I think there needs to also be townhouses. I think it also needs to have open space. I think there needs to be some retail. And I think it needs to be a network that can facilitate all of this, that allows for future growth and the forward thinkingness of this. And balancing all of those as important as possible.
Thank you. Cynthia, what about you? It seems pretty direct, but can you elaborate on your six-word story?
Yeah, so I bought here because I thought I could walk to the university. It's a 10-minute walk from my house to the edge of campus, but Adelphi Road is so loud and so dangerous and so unpleasant that I never walk to campus. I drive my car, I pay for parking, and yet I fit many of the criteria that were described at the beginning of this meeting. But because Adelphi Road is so unpleasant, it undercuts all the things that you would want from a walkable, livable, enjoyable community. And so, for example, we have someone in our community who only relies on the bus. And, we have raised the issue multiple times that it's a huge danger for him to cross Adelphi Road. And the only thing we've ever been able to get the county to do is put up some flashing lights. So for us, it's like the large roads, the speeding cars, it's just like completely undercut. I mean, we're sort of this weird little bubble once you're inside the neighborhood, but to leave our neighborhood and to try and deal with Adelphi Road and University Boulevard just is completely contrary to all the ideas that were presented and that even seem possible, from the more sustainable, livable, walkable community idea.
So thank you so much for that. It seems then that, to obviously put the positive spin on this, Cynthia, that we really need to focus on really safe crossings for bikes, pets, people getting to bus stops, that there's been plenty of emphasis on the fast roadways, that ultimately to make the station area work and be able to get to campus effectively and get to your house effectively, that pedestrian orientation and pedestrian safety is one of your bigger concerns.
Yeah, I will give you an example. I stand in the middle of Adelphi Road in the island with my dog with cars speeding by at 50 miles an hour, and they will not stop. They will not. So I'm standing out there with my dog, with cars going that fast, because that's just how Adelphi Road has developed. And so I think, one of the concerns is that there's only sidewalk on one side of Adelphi Road, right? And so for us to leave our neighborhood, the only way to walk up to the new station would be to cross Adelphi Road because the sidewalk's on the golf course side. And we've raised this issue at multiple meetings that unless there are significant changes, I mean, we just don't see how the transit would end up benefiting our neighborhood. And we're like, we're probably the second closest neighborhood. The closest neighborhood is the one sitting on the other side of University Boulevard from us, but we're probably the second closest neighborhood in terms of a residential neighborhood. So yeah, I mean, there's just, I think there's some issues that we've raised that we just don't see ever reflected in the feedback that's coming back from each step of this process.
Well, one of the things that I always find with station area planning is that, so you have the platform. And Cynthia, you raised a really really good point about the fact that, the platform might look like it's available and central in that circle, that 5-minute walk, but it doesn't mean that people can equally get to the platform. That 5-minute walk is kind of a planning tool that's very arbitrary, I say as a planner. And ultimately, we need to figure out the four quadrants of that major intersection. How can people get to the platform equally from all four quadrants? And, I've always found that transit planners, they want the most riders possible to make the most sense for transit. And so that is definitely something that this plan is looking at. Cynthia, I understand your frustration that it gets talked about a lot. Cynthia, I did put a comment here on the ideas wall too about the sidewalks in Adelphi Road. Are there other six-word stories Or do people have additional six word stories that have already put one up?
Yeah, you can suggest more than one. And while you're thinking about that, Beth, do you think you could zoom in just a little bit on
your Yes. Yep. Thank Is it you. A little difficult to see? Yeah.
Stephen wants to talk.
Go ahead. Stephen, what do you want to say?
Stephen, I think you're on mute. Can you unmute yourself?
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can.
Oh, great. Well, I think one of the fantastic opportunities of this Pebble on Station here is the fact that, unlike, I would say, the majority of Pebble Line stations all the way from, you know, from beginning to end, do not have currently a nice large green space which could be used for trails, not a park with the plazas and such like, but actually a real bit of woodland. That does exist at the present time in the southeastern corner of the map here, except that it's blotted out by a very large development. This is the Gilbane University of Maryland coalition, shall I call it, to build student housing and 81 townhouses. That will obliterate that entire area. We will no longer have a natural area to offer to anybody along the Purple Line. So that's my point. But I also have a sort of point about the organisation of this. You said at the beginning, or somebody did, that people on the councils and various county committees and so on should not be commenting in this, which makes good sense. I also think that Gilbane should declare their interests. Christian gave a good comment about what should be there, and it's precisely what Gilbane are proposing. So I do feel that if there are conflicts of interest, we should say so.
Thank sure. you. I mean, I'm happy to, if I may, by the speaker,
sure,
just
please.
Address that. As I mentioned, I do work for Gilbane Development. We are actively owned in this area and this sector. Plan, you know, would directly impact the land that we do own. We do have the Western Gateway, you know, moving forward. The website for that project is thewesterngateway.com. That is now up and running. I would also mention that the plan shown here is actually not the Western Gateway plan. It is the previous plan that is currently approved and has an active DSP called the Mosaic at Turtle Creek, which you'll notice is a substantially taller building with less access to Purple Line, less no sidewalks. It does have less road as well. And it also doesn't have any townhomes. And the amount of trees would be less as well. And so just to state on the record here that our plan is, as Steve mentioned, 300 below market graduate student housing units, and that would be below market, approximate to the university, and 81 townhouses with the road infrastructure and pedestrian infrastructure and a central park open space with stormwater management capacity on site for 1 million plus gallons, of which none of that currently exists now, and a retention of about 3.5 acres of trees, of which we're hoping to reforest the edges of with evergreens per our discussions with the neighbors. And then I would just add additionally that, you know, we're proposed from the sustainability component, we have secured offsite 10 acres to reforest trees, and continually talking with the neighborhood to gather ideas such as this. And that's why I'm a part of this, is to try to understand, is there additional things that we can do absent completely not doing a project that we can further help, because it is a balance. And that's why I expressed that from the beginning, that you know, this is a unique area with a Purple Line station near a university that requires a delicate touch. And we've been working, you know, with the university and the other key stakeholders for more than 4 years to try to craft a plan that addresses, you know, some of the needs that are really aching for in this area, with graduate housing, for sale housing, not $1 million homes, but homes that are equivalent to like Riverdale Park Station, approximate to transit. So anyway, I'm happy to speak further. I don't have a problem stating the interest. And I think many of the people on this line and probably others know the project. So hopefully that's a good introduction.
Yeah. Thanks. Hey, thank you, Christian.
Thanks, Christian. And thank you, Stephen. And I think, you know, we're recording all of this. So we definitely take note of you know, someone like Christian, who's from Gilbane, and the comments that he's included. So we also appreciate your comments, Stephen, just pointing that out. But we do have it recorded, so we're keeping track of who's saying what. But we also understand that Gilbane is interested in hearing what the community wants for this area so that they can try to, you know, make those kinds of improvements as well. But in the interest of time, I think maybe, Beth, do you want to move on to the second activity?
Yeah. And, you know, if you have other six word stories, like I said, this is not just it is kind of fluffy, but it's not just a fluffy exercise. It is actually a meaningful exercise where we could use these to create the vision. And if we have more, themes to work with and language to work with to create the vision. So please interrupt me and keep thinking about a possible six-word story that we can add here. So the other exercise is about what you value and what would you like to see. And so I as you were talking, Stephen, I put, what would we like to see? Nice, large green space opportunities for more trails. Stephen, does that generally capture your initial thoughts that you were expressing before?
Yes, that's very good. Thank you.
Okay, good. So what do you value in this station area? What would make it a more livable area? What would make it a place that you could get around in? How shall we identify your values here? Anyone can just jump right in and I'll capture them in the green sticky notes. What do you care about?
Well, just to start things off, this is Miriam Bader. I think open space is important, keeping the natural environment as much as possible, and then improving things like Adelphi Road. Then, you know, we really need, that would be a challenge. We really need to work on making that more pedestrian friendly.
Great. Thanks, Miriam. Other things, what would you want to, what do you value and what do you want to see? They're kind of the same question. So what should we care about that you care about?
I think placemaking is really important. I think someone referenced this earlier that, you know, this isn't really our community the way it is shown in the sector plan right now. It's those images in the presentation was well thought out, and that's what it could be. And so I think having a framework to be able to do that, I mean, that's the only way to achieve that. And currently there isn't that framework, which is why we're all here. And so what I think helps is access, and what I put in the chat box, because access allows for further growth and for everyone to enjoy this space. Exclusivity doesn't. And so that's important. And so in order to have access, you need a road network, you need sidewalks that connect. Those are some of the things that we're actually proposing to help, but we'll need to be consistent, I think, throughout this sector plan is, you know, if there isn't sidewalks on Adelphi, which I've walked there and understand that concern, we should try and get that. That should be a goal, and that should be, and also bike lanes and things that make sense, you know, around transit. So I would support those, and you know, we're not just saying these things, but also proposing to do them in our development that are limited focus within this overall 100-acre sector plan.
Thank you. Other ideas, what do you care about? What are your values here?
Can I make a comment, Steve?
Please, Stephen, go ahead.
Yeah, my comment is, I don't know how welcome it'll be, but if you look at the SaveGuildfordWoods.com website, you'll see a whole list of things which people would like to have. Okay, I know the thing is directed towards stopping the development, but that's not my point. The point is that if you look at the counter arguments, it gives you a very clear idea of what a very large number of people want. I mean, there's been 1,000 signatories of a petition, which is somewhat more than the number on this meeting, I think. Yep. But no, I'm not trying to push a particular view of how the woods should be developed. All I'm saying is that it could be a source for understanding what large number of neighbours think about it all. Thank you.
Thank you. Other things you care about? Let me get the map up.
Cynthia has added a comment. It's not only the ability to walk, but also something to look at. So I think she's talking about like an enjoyable pedestrian experience, right? A reason to stop at places. So we always like to have different sort of destinations or semi-destinations along the way to sort of break up a walk, make it interesting. Good lighting, so it's safe to walk. So illumination and pedestrian human scale lighting is what Cynthia is talking about there for the safety aspect of walking and destinations like parks and cafes. So destinations, breaking up the pedestrian experience with things to look at, places to stop, places to sit probably too, good lighting and just an enjoyable pedestrian experience. Thank you, Cynthia.
Yeah, I got all those down, I think, Cynthia. Other ideas of elements you want to see here, things you value that this plan should value too?
I just have one further comment.
And
that is the I would say, extraordinary or almost regional winner in a nasty intersection is 193 Adelphi Campus Drive. If anybody's ever managed to drive through that lot without having to stop at a red light, I don't know. I think you're very lucky. But something has to be done about that. If you're talking about pedestrians, my God, it's the most pedestrian hostile crossing I've ever come across. So please, that should be pretty high. I don't know what it's going to mean, if it's going to be tunnels for roads or bridges for pedestrians or what it is, or a big circle. I don't know, but somehow or other, that road intersection needs attention.
Stephen, that was 193 Adelphi Campus Drive. Is that what you said?
Myself off. Yes, exactly.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. What about connections, interactions with campus? I know a couple of you spend much of your time on campus in maybe normal conditions. Things that we should be thinking about with the relationship in the campus direction to the east?
Yeah, I mean, I would just add that there is an unsafe pathway through the woods right now, and so this is a community discussion. I think that some community members who access the campus use that frequently. Others don't want the access. I personally think the access would be better to have an updated formalized trail, because mm-hmm. people do use it, and so in our focus groups with people, many are supportive. I can understand why some might not want it, but I would think like lighting, a proper trail, blue lights to connect to the campus and make people feel safe within those woods, and an appropriate width path, public safety officials, that would be something that I think would help connect trails and connect communities and link back to the university.
Thank you, Christian. Other ideas, we're running on just under 10 minutes. Did anyone else have a six-word story that you want us to add?
I would like to call out, I know there's been a little bit of confusion for Brittany and Will. If you do want to speak up with your student hat on, you know, we were transparent that the both of you are graduate assistants with, you know, the commission. But if you are able to put your student hat on, and if you wanted to make any suggestions or recommendations based on your experience as a student at UMD about the connection between UMD and this neighborhood, if you wanted to add something, I think you should feel free.
Brittany, Will, would you like to add something to the discussion?
Oh man, I feel like I can speak. Yeah, I mean, like the School of Architecture is literally right there at the circle, just I think half the building is technically in the orange boundary. And, you know, we had that one strip of retail, which, you know, us students frequent Casey's Coffee, you know, religiously. And there's like the bubble tea spot. So there's like, you know, 3-4 options. There's a Subway. And I don't know, personally, as someone that grew up in the area, I'm glad that we have Casey's. I'm glad that we have these few offerings, but I feel like it could be a bit more integrated with like the commercial areas that are to the west on University Boulevard. You know, like why not have Pupuseria? You know, like why not have a place for sort of the small businesses that are located on the western part of this corridor? You know, I for me, it's like such a rich cultural history in this area, and just, you know, the people and demographics. And I feel like it sort of like feeds in that town-gown separation. And when you add like the racial aspect of it's like a lot and ethnic, you know, the large Latino population, I feel like we could do better in terms of bridging that gap, bridging that divide. And so I don't know, like maybe smaller space, like smaller commercial footprint, because that typically allows for small businesses to take up space without it being prohibitively expensive. So I'd like to add that. And then secondly, just as a student that likes to unwind after, you know, long classes, a place to have a beer would be pretty wonderful, to be able to like build community with my peers. It's otherwise just a commuter campus, you know, and it's really disappointing to be at the flagship university of the state of Maryland and people just drive to and from campus, and there's not really a place on this part of campus to sort of like build sort of informal community. And so those are my main comments. I do bike to campus from DC, and that last mile is a little treacherous, but it looks like y'all are integrating bike paths into it. So, you know, I don't have any strong comments there, but thank you.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna add that just integrating bike paths, just to make sure it's on here.
I would like to add too. I mean, I think the retail component of boutique, that's something that I personally think is needed. So I will divulge, I am an alumni of Maryland and also the architecture school. So I empathize with that relationship. And I agree that there should be something. I think the struggle with it, just to give you an answer really quick, is retail. There's so much retail on Baltimore Avenue. You need to have housing in order to support retail, which was indicated earlier. It doesn't take a lot of housing, but retailers won't go in here. You also need access. And so a lot of those things are will help to enable to have the boutique retail. So what I would like to see and what I remember needing is the same thing that you just mentioned, you know, more better than Rudy's Cafe. Rudy's Cafe is on campus and at, you know, the business school and is a great food, but, you know, there's only a quick casual there. There's no sit down restaurant that's on this side of campus. And so, you know, I would look to try to implement that in anything that we can do in our project. And that's going to be a market driven thing, unfortunately. However, I do think it's really important and would advocate. And I think that's a good note to have in this area to make it more of a placemaking thing. It's certainly a long campus drive. I think that can be consistent. It gets harder to do it on Moat and in the interior. So I would agree.
Great.
We have a comment from, we have a comment from Cynthia about, she's not sure if it exists or not yet, but a UMB shuttle stop at the corner of Adelphi Road and University Corner. So that's a suggestion if it's not already in place.
Sarah, can you read that? UMD shuttle stop at where?
The corner of Adelphi Road and University Corner.
It's going to be right where the station is. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think there is something close by, Cynthia, over by Graduate Hills. I would just note that we're proposing with Western Gateway a stop in the Central Park location. So there would be another stop there, and that would connect into that network to go with the other existing graduate student housing. Is that where the stop is? Is that what you're pointing?
I think this is the one we're studying right now. I think, isn't that where the other one is that you're talking about, Christian?
No, I think Graduate Hills is on a network on a UM shuttle route. It doesn't go anywhere else in the Adelphi sector plan. And so we would propose to put a dedicated UM shuttle stop centered. So right where the Mosaic at Turtle Creek is, about the dead center right there, a little bit more east, would be roughly where the UM shuttle stop would be that we're proposing. So there would be one, and there should be, and I would agree that if there isn't one, there should be one by Graduate Hills.
Sarah and others, is there a plan to reroute existing buses or add new buses to better connect to the station platform?
That is something I would have to defer to the project manager, the deputy project manager. I know we've had meetings with the various agencies that with the county and WMATA and the university's shuttle, UMD shuttle team. We have met with them. I'm not up to date personally on what the plans are for changing routes or plans or anything like that. So okay. That is a good question for the core team that we could find out.
Okay, that seemed like also a way to get at the issue of connecting campus and connecting new development to the station platform, shuttles, and kind of rerouting the bus system. So
could I make one additional comment,
yes,
please?
Go ahead, Steve.
One of the unfortunate things I would say about the university is that it really does not have the type of downtown that many other universities, and I think of University of Wisconsin or something like that, has a real sort of university, or the Charles area district around Hopkins. In my opinion, to do that, we need a few sort of offbeat types of stores. I would like to see, for instance, the used bookstore, which is currently down in that sort of thing, which is impossible on Route 1 at present because the rents are so high. that would make the area, shall we call it our area, very much more of a university downtown than Route 1 is, which is basically fast food joints and apartment buildings now. It's very sad to see that, but I think we could put a lot of those sorts of things right by attracting some of these more eclectic types of, and so people would travel from, okay, they do it in, no, they do it on the metro, would come to that from